We hear a lot about the diseases that affect people later in life, cancers, dementia, all sorts of cardiovascular issues, but we don't talk a lot about mental disorders and what's happening with people throughout the course of their lifetime. And as it turns out, BrainFX, Tracy, is detecting it at a very early stage, and it turns out that 1 in 3 people, in fact, throughout the course of their lifetime, would be affected by this, which is a staggering statistic. So what does BrainFX do to detect this cognitive impairment so early?
We're measuring what other tests have been missing, something that we were inspired by in our own frustration in clinical practice, because we would see that people who were struggling scored normally on our existing tests. So we use everyday function. We measure more complex cognitive skills and across the continuum from physical to mental health, looking at it a full picture of someone's neurofunction in order to be able to detect sooner and detect what we're not seeing on our traditional tests.
And so what are the tests you're doing?
We take the whole range of cognitive skills. We look at more than 30 skills. And we say, let's look at them in the context of the things that you need to do every day, like scheduling your day, being able to watch a pot on the stove without getting distracted, being able to make an appointment, prioritizing, listening to a voicemail and remembering it. So everything has a real-world application to it. So the idea is that everybody has their own unique BrainFX health profile, and that you're going to be able to look for the earliest opportunity to see change. So if there's some sort of decline for something that you've been strong at, we should be able to get in there and say, why is that happening for you? And that's our best opportunity to be most effective with intervention as well. And then monitor that over time, but also start to compare you to people who are very like you. We have something that's called our Living Brain Bank, and that's every person who ever does our assessments has the option to donate their assessment results to our Living Brain Bank. And then you can really compare somebody who not only is just age and gender or education mapped to you, but to say, you know, has the same diagnoses that you have. Maybe there's multiple, same medications right. That you're on. And then that's the best opportunity to compare yourself against others for early detection.
As you build up all of the patient profiles in the Living Brain Bank, there's going to be all kinds of opportunities to leverage machine intelligence.
Yes.
On the data. What kind of applications are you looking at?
That's what we're really excited about. So we're starting to partner with people who are working on biomarkers, who are collecting claims data, who are collecting population health data, EMRs, so electronic medical records, and then being able to pull all of that together, because really when you pull all those data sets together, you should get a 1+1=4, not just a 1+1=2, because we'll be able to uncover things that we just can't see right now when it comes to looking at someone's healthy function all the way through diagnosis. And the idea would be to be able to match that so you get a real personalized understanding of somebody's brain health, but to be able to then look at what would be most effective for that person when it comes to any sort of therapeutic intervention as matching their personal profile.
And that's a very interesting point, is how BrainFX can influence the treatment program or even be determinative ultimately
right.
In the treatment program. Is that the long-term roadmap?
So I think that's what's really exciting too. What's really interesting is that we have a lot going on in our space where people take biomarkers, right? So they're looking at a certain blood test or imaging, and they're trying to create that test that says, yes, you have a concussion. Yes, you have Alzheimer's. But the best test, and those are really important tests, but the very next question that you're going to ask if I tell you that you're going to have Alzheimer's in 10 years is,
yeah, what do I do?
What do I do? How's it affecting me right now? And that's what we do, is we look at the impact that it has on your everyday functions so that you can get really practical what next action plans, care plans, that really help maximize your quality of life on an everyday basis. And that's where the big difference comes for you, for your family, for the provider who's delivering that care, but also for the healthcare system and the payers, because that's where you can maximize any sort of impact on cost too.